still dumping on Joe Rogan. Still doing it. It's more Joe Rogan fans.
Yeah. Yeah. Keep this in mind. I don't give a flying fuck what Joe Rogan's opinions are on anything. I will say I probably agree with him more than I disagree with him. But I don't agree with this idea of promoting this phony-ass masculinity that he promotes. All because he's got a bunch of tattoos and he lifts or whatever the fuck he does. I mean, if you work out because, like, you tap into that positive energy of, like, taking care of yourself, and it's probably, like, a spiritual thing for you. I know that it is for a lot of people. Like, that's one thing. But I think a lot of people work out because, like, they just want to look good. And I think that's such a lame reason to do anything. I fucking hate vain people so much, obviously. I don't know if, like, I purposely try to, like, make myself as ugly as possible because that's how much I hate vanity, which I'm assuming is probably another form of vanity, you know? Taking pride and not giving a fuck about your physical appearance. And it's not like I really take pride in it. I just don't care, you know? It's, like, not something that I'm, like, conscious of, I guess. Like, there are all these other things that I'm conscious of that I don't think a lot of people are conscious of. So, if I'm not conscious of, like, how my hair looks or the fact that, like, my pants look weird or, you know, I look stupid, you know, like, I'm not worried about that. Like, that's not something that I'm thinking about. But I realize that I guess that's what makes me, like, not feminine or whatever, like, in the modern sense. Because modern women are trained to, like, only pay attention to that. So if you're wondering, like, why modern women seem really shallow, it has everything to do with, like, you know, the beauty products and magazines and catalogs and all this stuff that they push on everybody to, like, just make us buy a bunch of crap that, like, doesn't solve the existential crisis that is living in this world. And women are the absolute worst about this. And now you have men that act just like women, which is even more obnoxious. But, like, yeah, I don't fall in line with that at all. Maybe to a fault, like, maybe I should, like, try a little harder to, like, care about my physical appearance. Hey, I'm not, like, fat and disgusting, and I'm skinny and disgusting. I look like I'm on coke all the time, but, you know, people don't complain about that. Like, they should complain about that. They should complain about people starving themselves because they want to be, like, a size 2. But I guess you don't really have, like, a morbid, like, a morbid starvation problem. Way that you do, you know, the obvious obesity problem in the United States of America. I don't judge fat people, by the way. I have so many fat friends, it's ridiculous. I mean, I guess anybody's fat compared to me, though, right? That's true. That's very true. But, like, I'll be real with you, Vortex. Like, and I know, I'm probably going to get some people to leave my channel when they hear me say this, but, like, I am attracted to women. I'm not going to do anything about that. I mean, it doesn't matter. Like, I'm not going to do anything about any kind of attraction that I have to anybody, because I don't want what comes with that. Just such a pain in the ass, like, having to, you know, live up to any kind of expectation. But yeah, so in the previous video I was talking about this chick guitar player. She's a guitarist for this metal band that performed on this podcast where I did a comedy set. And she was kind of a bigger girl. She was so cool, man. Like, she was, like, the coolest person. And she just seemed so chill and, like, she's really down to earth. And, you know, I really liked her shit. She really liked my shit. You know, we appreciated each other's art. We appreciated each other's existence. As women, we appreciated that, okay? I'm kidding. Real women don't give a fuck about being a woman, okay? Like, we just exist. We're just human. That's all it is, y'all. That's all it is. People that obsess about identity, I hope y'all kill yourselves, because you're so fucking stupid and annoying, and nobody would care if you killed yourself. Okay? I'm just gonna say it right now. Anyway. Amy, I think that if you do a video and you don't tell people to kill themselves, like, you owe people something for that. You know, like, that needs to be, like, your classic insult. Like, yeah, and kill yourself. But anyway, what was I saying? This really hot chick. Her name was Shania. So, yeah, really, really cool chick. But, yeah, like, if I were a man, I would totally go after this girl. I'll tell you that. If I were an actual man with an actual dick, an actual ball sack, I would totally ask this girl out. Well, I would just ask her to marry me based off of how good she can shred, all right? Because it was just so beautiful. It was one of the best displays of actual talent I've ever seen. But yeah, man, she would. She was a bigger girl. If I had to put her at a size, I'd say that she might have been like a size 8, possibly size 10. But she was so beautiful, and she was talented, and she was cool, and funny, and interesting, and she had really nice hair, and, you know, it's like, I don't know what point I was trying to make. I think I was trying to stress that, like, you don't have to be any particular size to be attractive, but you should at least be healthy. You should be at the healthiest weight for whatever size you are. So, you know, if that means lose a little weight, gain a little weight, you should get on that shit. Because, like, you should treat your body with respect, and you should care about yourself, and I mean, that's what's so sad to me, but whenever I see, like, people that are really obese, it's like, you just obviously, like, don't care about your body. Like, you don't care, like, and I mean, so many people that they call themselves fat phobic or whatever, I hate these people too. I hope they kill themselves too, but anyway, it's just like, if you were actually fat phobic, if you actually, like, cared about people, you become, like, a physical trainer. You know, you wouldn't just, like, troll people. Or, like, make fun of them for being fat. Yeah, this is what I'm talking about. It's so easy to just, like, make fun of things. But most of the time when people mock stuff, they don't really have an actual joke, number one. Number two, like, whatever they say has already been said over and over and over again, so there's really no point reiterating it. Number three, what they're saying is not interesting. So if they're going to say it,
they need to say it in an interesting way that's actually funny, that actually proves some sort of point. They never do that. But nobody cares about anything. They definitely don't care about human beings. When I see a person that's like really obese, it just makes me really sad. And I see it all the time because I work in restaurants. I've worked in restaurants for a long, long time. Fast food. So, yeah, I see shining examples every single day of precisely what I'm talking about right now. It's people that don't care that their body is a temple, you know? And we all have to work on that in some way. We all have vices that we need to work on. But, you know, that's one vice in America that, you know, people aren't concerned about. And it's like if they try to lose weight, I feel like the reason why people aren't successful is because they don't do it in a way that they'll remember, you know? Yeah, but circumstances change, though, you know? A lot of times, you know, people lose weight and then they'll start eating again whenever something happens, you know? Like a tragedy or... I don't know. So many different things factor into the same, but you can't just, like, whittle it down. Like, oh, well, it's because of this, you know? I know. I've never had the problem of, like, you know, having to lose weight. You know, obviously. Like, I'm really excited because I gained some weight. I think I gained, like, a pound and a half, you know? And that's exciting for me. But, yeah, I mean, like, I look at myself with, like, my bony-ass shoulders. And, I mean, I don't like my rib cage sticking out. That's not good. That's not a positive thing for me. You know, I'm too skinny. So, it's really important to, you know, evaluate yourself. Be like, is there something I can work on? Probably. Maybe I need to work on that. And if I don't want to work on it, I need to pray to the Lord for discipline. Because, you know, there are definitely going to be days like, you know, like when you get in that routine and you're motivated. But then there's that one day where you just, like, don't have motivation whatsoever. And, like, that's when you're really going to be tested. Are you still going to do it even though you don't want to do it? You know, you got to have faith in the bigger picture. You know, you might not have faith in that specific thing on that specific day, but... if you have faith in the bigger picture, if you have faith in, like, whatever goal you're trying to accomplish in the long run, then you'll do it regardless of your feelings about it, you know? Anyway. I say so many things in one video. I really don't know if it's any good. You know, I notice, like, people viewing it, and I'm like, oh, this guy, this many views. Like, but I wonder, like, how many of those people actually watched the whole thing. Probably very few of them. Probably got sick of it after, like, 2 minutes. Well, your mouth, though, man. You're fucking rough. I know I am. But here's the thing, I'm a really nice person, though. Like, if you met me on the street, you'd have to assume that I was a really, really nice person. You would have to assume that. Yeah. But see, my comedy, or whatever the fuck this is on this channel, you know, it's a completely different thing. Because it's like, all this stuff I internalize, all this stuff that I don't say out loud. And if I do say it out loud, like, people get mad at me about it. So yeah, I understand why people leave. It's totally understandable. But, yeah. You can't expect me to not do this, though. Because this is, like, who I am. I have to get on to myself about that shit. Because, like, for a little while, you know, I didn't do this, not just this channel, but, like, I didn't want to put myself out there because, like, I know what I'm capable of. I know that, like, I'm very, like, polemical. I'm very opposed to, like, everything that people do. And I can't stand most people. I think most people are shitty and should commit suicide. Yeah, like, yeah, that's a harsh judgment right there. But it's because, you know, I see all this bullshit, you know? There's just so much futility in everything that people do. And it's just so depressing to, like, watch all these sheep day in and day out just self-destruct. And I'm seeing myself self-destruct in certain ways, you know? Certain things that I do, I'm like, man, that's not good. You need to work on that. That's not good. You need to really pray for forgiveness, and you need to pray for the courage to, like, resist this urge to just, you know, I don't want to say, like, commit suicide or anything, because I'm not on that level anymore, but, like, just, I don't know, man. I really hate this world. I do not want to be here. But, I mean, it's not a choice. Like, I didn't choose to be here, and, you know, my mother chose to have me. She didn't choose to keep me, though. She rejected my ass. On Thanksgiving Day. All fucking days. But, see, this is an example of my rejection of this world, okay? So, for a lot of people, they can use their smartphone to bitch about the world, but it doesn't make any sense because they're going along with the world to bitch about the world. But I realize that I'm a hypocrite because there are certain things that I do. I mean, this camcorder I use is a form of technology. I'm driving a car, that's a form of technology. I got this fucking credit card. But, you know, I fucking hate smartphones, though, man. I hate them. I absolutely hate smartphones. I hate your smartphone. Everybody in the Vortex has a smartphone. I don't hate you, but I hate your smartphone. And your smartphone hates you, too, because it wants you to be fucking stupid. All right? It does. It wants you to be stupid, so then eventually it can kill you, and that's what you deserve.